This is a 3-year-old biracial disabled boy in a medical stroller phone cover that I can buy on Amazon. No, I'm not being an edgy straight white male comedian. This is a real thing, and it was made by an algorithm, not a human. This is an algorithmically generated children's video on YouTube. Content made to fit the most popular search terms. So when tired parents put their baby in front of an iPad, it is autoplayed by the YouTube algorithm. Dodgy videos, which are monetized and made by the thousands by anonymous companies. 1 minute a kid is singing along with Elsa from Frozen, the next they are watching Peppa Pig getting tortured, Spider-Man dropping the hand, or an Indian woman singing about fingering. The internet has not worked out the way we thought it would.
My name is Blindboy Boat Club, and I'm an adult human who dresses up like a fool to get attention.
We're in the middle of a digital revolution with consequences we could never predict. Jobs, housing, mental health, human rights. We appear to be worse off than previous generations. In this series, we look at how the feckin' internet is fucking things up for us all, and the pricks who are taking advantage of it.
And look at this lovely drone shot. Every TV show has one.
We're gonna find out why we're getting bothered, who's bothering us, and what aftershave they're wearing.
The internet has brought chaos. Yeah, I can order a burger and a picture of the Virgin Mary in my jocks at 4 a.m. But the lad delivering it is on 50p an hour and the burger is made out of pixelated meat. Myself and a team of qualified investigators are looking at the unctuous bastards taking advantage of this chaos. We'll find the fraud boys who use Instagram to get teenagers to launder dirty money.
We'll freeze their credit cards for good.
It's literally in the banks.
We seek out the dodgy investment men who promise you riches but piss in your britches.
So if you do this for 90 days, you never need to work a day in your life.
And we'll demonstrate how deepfakes and bent algorithms are making it impossible for anyone to tell what is real. Oh, yeah.
Point of Guinness.
Give me the paddy's nectar, man. Oh.
Did you change the locks on the flat, man? I can't get in. The flat's in use for the next few hours.
I rented it out to some internet pornographers.
Porn people?
Yeah,
Gabriel Byrne, puppet porn.
Algorithmically generated content, so there's porn for every search term ever. Cash money, baby.
It's time to take down the usual suspects.
Chief Mary and Joseph.
So we're taking you here to a London Irish pub. Connect with our roots, man. Get away from the fans. It's not even a real Irish pub. It's one of those Irish pub concepts. All these people are actors.
Does anyone want to buy some meat?
Drink, thick, girls, ass. There's only two genders.
This was a pret-a-manger 2 months ago.
Stop getting your jocks in a heap, man. Anyway, don't you have some serious social issues to discuss and we'll come back to this conveniently resonant situation later.
Trust me, I told you
it'll
pop, you get me?
Blood, this is more than what I expected.
Hot, wet cash. Yum, yum.
He just used to post up cash on his Instagram page, pictures of jewellery, watches, all the stuff that you see when somebody has money. All I simply needed to do was give him my account.
That sounds perfectly reasonable.
A whole generation have grown up with Instagram, hoovering up impossibly aspirational content into their eye holes. Cars, money, luxury chins.
But how can a broke child with very little opportunities get that lifestyle? Luckily, Instagram can help with that too. Here's the fraud boys.
And this shit real cash, man.
Fraud boys are money launderers that use Instagram to recruit teenagers who have clean bank accounts. They want your squares, or a debit card as a banker would say. They then use these cards to move dirty money in, clean money out. Fucking genius. Dog in a car wash.
My bank accounts were shut. It practically ruined my life.
Victims' bank accounts are shut down permanently and they get done for money laundering. But because the fraud boys do their work over the net, they just disappear. These stinky adults usually stay completely anonymous. But we wanted to squint at the child grooming gambeens. So we got Britain's most innocent-looking journalist, Nicola, to pose as bait. A 16-year-old with a bank account cleaner than a fresh pair of wash jocks. Before long, a fraud boy slithers out of cyberspace to give us his four-point plan on how to be a prick.
Yeah, I grabbed you a seat because it was just so busy.
Step one, waste no time in explaining how the money laundering works. Step two, promise that this is just the start of a class new life. Step three, explain how to hide the card from your parents. Step four, wreck a teenager's life and fuck off. This is bleak and grim. I need to rub a dog and go eat an ice cream. The only thing these money laundering charmers are afraid of is frozen credit cards. So let's see how they react to one in real life. See? A fake card and a block of ice. It is both a visual pun and an amusing object. That's satire, not comedy, which means I can claim a tax-free exemption in Ireland. Turns out that County Line's money launderers are quite paranoid because not one of them showed up. The ice was melting, but we kept an eager vigil, waiting for the elusive money badgers. Day two and the slanty orange sun vomits on the concrete Stratford slabs. No fraud boys, we were losing hope. We were ready to abandon the sting. Holy fuck, he's taking a piss in the ice. Fair play. Christ. But hark! Nicola finally makes contact with a fraud boy.
I left my card. You can go and get it.
Where did you leave it?
There's like some recycling bins.
And by the recycling bin, where the fuck are you going on?
So there's a sheet?
Yeah,
it's under that.
It's not under no sheet.
Like I left it there.
There's no card there.
While meticulously planned, we hadn't accounted for our subject not knowing what a blanket was. He took some time to think about it. Hide his identity, a bit late for that, and try again. But this time he had a class plan. He was going to use his hands.
What? Lift the sheet or pocket?
Well done. Oh, yeah.
It's in ice.
Fair fox, man.
Yeah.
Oh, God, they must have frozen my account. Do you have a hairdryer? You can just use that.
Our first lad was visibly startled. I hope he didn't go away and have a panic attack in a phone box. There's the mayor of Stratford. He's an openly gay cat. Right, second lad wants full penetrative japes.
I left my card in a safe spot.
Where did you leave it?
He's a good sport. Very proud set of ankles, even from a distance.
Can you see it?
Yeah, inside the icebox.
Have a crack at that ice, sir. Go on.
Oh, they must have frozen my account.
What?
He didn't give a fuck.
How did he manage to do that?
He's nonplussed by this.
It's literally in ice.
Yeah.
You can get it out, you just gotta wait a bit for it to maybe melt.
He doesn't know irony.
Let me try and figure something out for you then.
This guy's a fucking idiot. Alright, fair balls. He's gone, is he? No, he's back. He's after bringing his dad. Is he back with his dad? Right, the dad's having a look at this. Fuck that. Okay, fair enough. They're back, my man. He's after getting those gloves that you get in a pound shop that smell like a condom. Okay. Gone again, is he? Come back with a hammer, wraps it in a shroud, lifts it up like it's a square Christ. It's a fake credit card and a block of ice surrounded by a piss-soaked blanket, sir. You silly, silly agent. And he's dropped it. I need a pint.
How does someone put a square in a block of ice?
Ah, bollocks.
Imagine a world where every word ever written, every picture ever painted, and every film ever shot could be viewed instantly in your home via an information superhighway.
25 years ago, a new age dawned. It was amazing. You could send messages across the globe and buy stuff they didn't sell in Asda. The future was unlimited. We'd have the sum knowledge of humanity at our fingertips. Connectivity would mean empathy. We'd usher in a new age of peace and love. But it didn't turn out like that. Web 1.0 died, the shining city on the hill fell, the dot-com bubble burst. After 9/11, nothing felt safe. Filled with fear, governments and corporate giants realized that the internet was not about giving everyone information, it was about getting everyone's information. Then, when hot Steve Jobs put a computer in everyone's hand, it all changed. Now, everywhere we go, we carry a little box that spies on us, selling our deepest secrets to governments, companies, and con men. And we are left to figure out how to act in a world where you can't tell what's real. I was in the pub because my flat was being used to film increasingly bizarre, algorithmically generated pornography.
Shout into my horn!
Triggered snowflakes! You can't say anything on the internet today without SJW silencing you. They're coming for Piers Morgan, man. Piers Morgan!
Half the stuff that you defend online would be considered completely unacceptable if it happened in real life.
Bullshit. You have the same rules online as in real life. That's the man I am.
Hold on a minute. That lad, he's shown his dick to a woman who never asked to see it.
What'd you think of that?
Fuck off!
Sluts. Nice guys, they always come last.
He's a criminal. Call the police, please.
You do that all the time on Facebook Messenger. All the time. You did it to my aunt.
That is different.
What about that? A swastika on the pub notice board.
Why are you making me drink in a Nazi pub? Nah.
And that's Cookie. He's handing out free newspapers in exchange for personal secrets.
This paper's free if you give me a secret.
Now he's selling those secrets to Coca-Cola executives in the toilets.
That is deeply unsettling.
And this chap, he's just told his friends that he's considering suicide and they're encouraging him to do it.
I'm thinking of ending it.
I think that's a great idea.
Yeah, go for it. You could shoot yourself in the head.
Jump off a building.
Dry yourself in the bathtub.
Slit your wrists.
Jump in front of a bus.
Take a bath with a hairdryer.
Sick bastards. Where is their empathy?
You did this last week on Twitter.
It doesn't count if I tell a celebrity to kill themselves.
Yes, it does.
No.
You see, this is all stuff that happens every day on social media. And we just think it's okay because the internet is new and we don't know the rules yet. But when it happens in a pub, even you agree that it's unacceptable.
I don't know, man. On the one hand, you do make some good points. But on the other hand, it sounds like a cultural Marxist EU plot to tax my income and give my house to a Syrian. Let's do shots!
The internet doesn't require your participation to ruin your life.
How are you, brother?
What's good? The crack?
It can destroy your identity without you even knowing.
There was a knock at my door. Police were just starting to barge into my house. And she says, I'm arresting you on suspicion of downloading indecent images of children.
My photos were stolen off social media over a number of years, and they were used to groom and blackmail young girls.
How did the police make this mistake?
They added an extra digit to the IP address. There was a typing error on the application.
An IP address is a big, long number.
Uh-huh.
They got this wrong.
Yeah.
And because they made an error, you were arrested for downloading child pornography, which you never did.
So I had messages from this girl saying, I think there's someone pretending to be you.
This is the woman who did it.
Yeah, she was sending them dildos, dick pics, and explicit images saying that it was me in the pictures.
How old were they?
Anything from like 14 years old up, kids.
When they put me in the cell, that was when it dawned on me how massive this was.
Yeah.
Wow, they really think I'm a paedophile. They said, you know, we never get this stuff wrong.
Yeah.
As I was with vulnerable children, I couldn't wait for while this was going on.
You had an adult female paedophile.
Yeah, yeah.
You taking your identity to try and get sexual images off children.
Basically, yeah. She got three years, I think her sentence was.
No part of her conviction has anything to do with stealing your identity.
When I spoke to the police, they said to me, no crime's been done against you. I could be walking down the road and there could be a bloke on the other side of the road that wants to come over and hit me because I've been talking to his underage little sister or whatever.
They've made a mistake, but it's me that's had to face the hell.
So one digit fucked up your life for many years.
Yeah.
The internet is a shared hallucination where you don't know what to believe. What is real? Who can you trust? If I click on this link, will I find an article about what child celebrities look like today? Or will it just sell my data to Albanian sextortionists or Boko Haram? If only there was someone we all trusted.
It comes down to a moment when
when you live up to your name, when you hold your ground and turn possibility into opportunity.
This is Mike Tyndall. He's a ball-playing world champion man. He is married to a royal person. We can trust him. Look at him with his eggy ball and his head.
Already a winner.
Michael has been UFX brand ambassador for years. Maybe we should all whip out our phones and invest in him. But it turns out that UFX is a melted wrench.
I came across UFX on Facebook, a sponsored ad. Looked very good. Some famous faces on there, Mike Tyndall in particular, that gave it quite a large amount of credibility. I was never in it for Ferraris or yachts. I just wanted to pay the mortgage off.
UFX lures you into the insanely risky business of derivative trading with the promise of amazing rewards for little outlay.
If you have an account with $1,000, it will allow you to open trades up to $400,000.
When you sign up, you are smacked in the chops by emails with Mike's face splattered all over them. And then a broker starts calling again and again and again, telling you that you're missing out the chance of a lifetime and you need to give them your money. So what do you do?
I'd invested $100,000, $114,000 to be exact. And very, very quickly, I'd lost everything.
We clicked on Mike's face and got a call back from a broker. Full disclosure, although the audio is real, we have hired a professional actor to play the part. We were wondering how a company could fool such clever people. Turns out that they used an ingenious process called not telling the truth. First, they tell you that UFX traders know how shares will move before they move.
Because, you know, our traders obviously know how, you know, the movements are going to happen, what's going to happen to assets. It's horse racing, but knowing how each horse works, knowing how what horse is going to run faster than the other.
The trainer, like, knows which horse is going to win.
Exactly.
Then they tell you, you'll get a 100% return every fucking year.
If I was to put £20,000 in, what growth could I expect?
In a conservative way, if you're making around, you know, $300, $400 a week, you wouldn't say no to that, right?
Yeah.
Exactly.
And they finish you off by pulling down their pants, spreading their hoop, and farting out that they only make money when you do, when the opposite is true.
Do you make money if I lose?
No, Emma, that's not what happens.
But you're really clear that UFX only makes money if my trades win.
Exactly.
And how are we so confident that they're lying about returns? Because it says so on their own feckin' Facebook page. More than 80% of people lose their money. But who cares about the lies? The insanely pushy selling, the lies, the never-ending calls, the lies. Never mind all that. Listen to Mike in his glory hole.
If you ever need any help, they're always at the end of the phones.
I received a call from my VIP account manager. And he said that it was possible to get out of the situation that I was in and continue trading. But he asked me for another $160,000. That's when it hit me that there was no help, the money had gone, and that there was no going back.
They're quality guys, I love catching up with them, so it's always good to be here.
Everybody wants to be the Wolf of Wall Street, but the real wolves are investment ball sacks like UFX, making it appear that high-risk trading is as easy as tapping an app on your phone. Like Candy Crush, except it'll ruin your life.
The featured UFX user agreed to withdraw his complaint against UFX upon accepting a financial settlement with no admission of liability by UFX.
The company which runs the UFX brand is licensed, and UFX operates in full compliance with all applicable laws, regulations, and the license. UFX provides its customers with full disclosure regarding the risks involved in online trading in a clear and transparent manner, and it refrains from providing customers with any specific investment advice.
We tried on multiple occasions to contact Mike Tyndall via his representatives. However, we received no reply. After a five-year ambassadorship, Mike Tyndall ceased all online posts and his association with UFX in May 2019.
UFX separates Gen Xers from their money. If only there were some sexy investment bastards for us broke millennials.
On average, every single day, an adult looks at their phone 174 times a day. That's one thing that people love. People also like to make money. How about doing two at the same time?
As a person who had no experience before, I can now make money from a $7 trillion a day financial industry.
In life, you're either all in or you're out. You either want to change your life or you don't.
So what I want to show you guys today is iMarket Live.
iMarkets claims to be an investment advice company. You pay a monthly fee for secret advice on high-risk foreign exchange trading, or Forex as wankers call it. But that's just a disguise. The only advice you need is to stay the fuck away from them. Regulators in the UK, France, Belgium and other less sexy sounding places have released warnings about IML, but those warnings aren't on Instagram, so no one fucking knows. They target young kids, hook them on a monthly subscription and then advise them that the real way to make money is to recruit other kids. That's right, it's a multi-level marketing scheme, which is just like a pyramid scheme, but unfortunately it's legal.
You can take the money you have in your bank and learn to multiply it.
Multi-level marketing schemes have been around for years, but social media has turbocharged them. And boy, does iMarkets love social media.
Let's face it, guys. They're called smartphones for a reason.
It uses YouTube, Instagram and Facebook friend networks to empty the pockets of the gullible.
This is not something they teach you at school, not something they teach you at university.
We wanted to see these assholes in action, so we sent our young, poor entrepreneur, Tim, to meet Vincent Iannucci.
Anyone can really learn this skill.
He is a platinum 5,000 iMarkets guy, whatever that means. He claims to have recruited 500 people into this triangular investment opportunity. Straight away, Vincent began painting a picture of a worry-free life that Tim could have.
During the day, you've got 5 minutes here, 10 minutes here, you put a couple of trades on, and that'll be more than your weekly salary.
No.
Really?
Yeah. Okay, Vinny, with your trusting scarf, let's cut to the chase. I'm going to need a montage of lies, please.
Our results are much higher than standard trading results.
Lie.
In City, their margins are 66.
Untruth.
Our trades are more successful.
Fib.
So these people make more than the banks?
Yes.
Arse.
Our trades are more accurate.
No.
Because of the software we use.
Shite talk.
So we are winning 75% of the time.
Fat words. All great lies, Vinny. But if you wouldn't mind, just give me one giant lie, please.
So if you do this for 90 days, you are financially free. You never need to work a day in your life.
Bullshit!
But Vincent finally moved on to what iMarkets is really about, recruiting.
If three friends join you, the company will start paying you $150 a month.
That's like a pyramid.
Yeah, everything's a pyramid. Catholic Church, who's in charge? The Pope. Right? Down here. So everything's like a pyramid.
If someone tries to defend the integrity of their business by comparing it to the Catholic Church, run a fucking mile.
So I said to my mum that I was meeting you today, and she said this could be a bit risky.
When you speak to people, you should always speak to people that have what you want.
What?
Or have the success you want. Because if I ask my mum or my wife...
You for real, Vinny?
They would always tell me, if you don't need your job, you know, secure, it's not right. Change the direction of your life.
I will.
Okay.
But Slick Vinny wasn't done yet. He took us to an iMarkets conference where they cram all the people they're recruiting into one room. Things got really, really weird.
There's a lot of stuff in the Bible that relates to this.
What?
Jesus was the best networker ever. What did he do?
Maybe.
He didn't go to the disciples. All he said is, you follow me. He got 12 people and he built Christianity from 12 people. So the networking's the same.
What the fuck, Vincent?
I believe it relates to Christianity.
What? Are you fucking serious, Vincent? Is he taking the piss?
So Forex is within Christianity because it's about trading, and it says in the Bible,
stop, Vincent.
It says it's good to engage in foreign trade.
Look, God loves a trier. Jesus.
So what does it say?
I'm not sure exactly. Ezekiel 11, it's about trading in there.
What about the bit where Christ kicked the shit out of the moneylenders, Vincent? What about that bit? Jesus was a socialist.
This company is turning people onto faith.
I was skeptical of Vincent. I didn't know if he was hoodwinking me. But then this lad stood up.
The information you're about to hear today could blow you out of this stratosphere.
Meet Pastor Manuel Kings. He combines running a born-again ministry with being an iMarkets hype man.
So you had better fasten your seatbelt.
Yart, fuck trading. iMarkets is here to save your soul.
The stage has been set for the Antichrist. And then when that time comes, it's going to come onto you like a thief in the night.
Yes, Manuel. The stage has been set for the Antichrist. That's the devil. And the devil is going to come in the night to steal all of your things.
So when he comes, and they're going to lock up your monies on the banks. Whereby you cannot sell, you cannot buy, you cannot work.
And when the devil comes into your house, you won't be allowed to go to work or make any money.
But once you can't do that, you'll now be forced to take the mark.
And then you'll be forced to take the mark of the devil unless you work for iMarkets.
And the people, you're going to have women with suffering, you know, children. Keep them in so much hunger. Once you're in that state, anything they tell you for food, you will do it.
So iMarkets has a role.
iMarkets has a role.
If you don't sign up for iMarkets, you and your family will be violated by Beelzebub. I didn't say it, he said it, and I believe him. God's talking to everyone about iMarkets. He even visited our undercover reporter, Jonah, in a dream. So we sent him to hijack the next iMarkets conference to tell the real truth about IML. We thought Jonah's religious visions would get us thrown out. We were wrong.
Can I just say something?
Yes.
It's my first time here, and I had a dream last night. It was IML. I don't know why.
We started off by saying it was like a pyramid scheme.
People say, oh, this company is like a pyramid scheme, but hey, what's wrong with pyramids? Egypt had pyramids.
Round of applause. That was a small bit odd. Yeah. Let's get more explicit. And,
they say, the people online say the company is under investigation in a few countries.
No reaction.
And they say they inflate their wealth, but they look so rich.
Anybody offended? How about some grooming?
The company targets teenagers. What's the problem?
Anything?
People say, like, They go around, they high-risk trading.
And instead of throwing us out...
And, yeah.
Applause. Fucking hell. All right, just say anything and get the fuck out, cos...
I love these people, IML, ISIS. Yeah, thank you.
Round of applause. This is normal. People shouldn't be so desperate to get out of poverty that they'll believe in anti-Satan recruitment schemes.
This is not how it's supposed to work.
They shouldn't clap when they're told they're being lied to.
This is not how it's supposed to work.
Teenagers shouldn't be so disillusioned that money laundering starts to look like the only sensible option.
This is not how it's supposed to work.
The internet is 30 years old. It shouldn't be a wild west of data stealing, high-risk trading, 80% lose their money, Jesus endorses iMarket, so you can trust Mike. Squint at my Instagram, flash the cash, lifestyle content, shilling, shithawks, taking advantage of any human who's hoping for a better life.
It's not the way it's meant to be.
No.
We contacted iMarket, Vincent Iannucci and Emmanuel Kings for comment on multiple occasions, but they did not respond.
The internet has created a breakdown of reality. Fake news influences every election and referendum we have. Sometimes fake news is sensationalist satire that exists because your granddad will click on it. Other times it's the product of a disinformation campaign by a foreign government to disrupt and confuse society. It's not just fake news that's fucking with reality though. Algorithmically generated content is deconstructing the media we consume. The algorithm is created by what you and I search for. The more we search for a subject, the more the algorithm suggests it back to us. But humans are dark, especially in the privacy of a search bar. So the content gets darker and darker. This means more conspiracy theory videos, more far-right content, more Jordan Peterson calmly dismantles libtard feminist while Ben Shapiro French kisses a swan. Because the algorithm says someone somewhere will pay for it. That's why porpoise porn is real, and forced gay by aliens, and forced gay by islanders, and forced gay by the school mascot. And that's okay, that's grand, go for it. It also means the bizarrely inappropriate kids' videos we saw at the start of the programme. If we don't know what's fake, how will they know those videos are fake? And what about deepfakes? Deep learning computer reproductions of real people, saying and doing things that never happened. What if it was a politician? That shit could start World War III. This is Donald Trump in the Ritz Hotel in Russia. Observing some ladies doing pisses on each other. It's not, of course. You know that because this is a segment on deepfakes. And also because it doesn't look quite right. It doesn't look quite right because we're on a BBC Three budget. We just had a green screen, a lad in a wig and two women we got off an extras website. In fact, we only had a meeting room because we couldn't afford a green screen studio. But it's close. If we can make this on a laptop, out of cardboard and Pritstick, what can governments do? What can rich people do? How will we know what's real? This is Scarlett Johansson at the start of a porn movie she never made. This is Nicolas Cage in every movie ever made. This is Steve Buscemi and Jennifer Lawrence. How do we know that this is really Donald Trump? How do we know this is really Jeremy Corbyn saying those words? How do we know that Jacob Rees-Mogg isn't a puppet? No, really, how do we know he's not a 3D-rendered, computer-generated, Gaussian blurred meat puppet being operated by a cartel of marmalade makers in Maidstone? how will we know what's real in 5 years? We created that Donald Trump pee video because we knew it would go viral. Because it's the Donald Trump pee tape and everybody is searching for it. We couldn't understand why no one had done it before until we went to put it up. Nobody would show it, even though we broke no rules. Nobody. Not porn sites. Not even sites that show people being beheaded for fun. Everywhere, it was taken down in two shakes of a lamb's tail. It turns out you can deepfake anything except Donald Trump. But who's taking it down? Is it the CIA? Is it the Russians? Lads, for fuck's sake, this is David Icke shit, like, you know? What, like, get a proper studio at least. I don't want to be doing this type of stuff. Can I get a Fanta? That's the headquarters of British intelligence. The IRA had a crack off it in the 90s. Are we allowed to say on camera that that's, you know, the headquarters of British intelligence? We just pixelated. When I think of James Bond, I see a 50-year-old functioning alcoholic in a tuxedo who exhibits questionable levels of sexual consent. This is not the case today, and James Bond has been replaced by a lad called Simon, who has a twiglet-dusted neckbeard and a heart condition. And he doesn't ski parachute from a private plane into East Berlin. He sits in a server farm in Dartmoor watching you wank through your iPhone camera. I'm talking about cyber warfare, weaponizing fake news, and targeted hacking. And Britain's not even the worst. Parts of China have a social credit system. What you do online and in the real world is tracked by the government. If you score low, you can't travel, get a job, and you're socially shamed. Imagine tweeting at 2 a.m. that Boris Johnson scratches his arse on the carpet like a terrier, and then waking up the next morning to find that your Oyster card doesn't work. It sounds like the plot of a manic self-published science fiction novel, but this is the actual world we live in now. So what's next? What do I know? I'm just a clown with a plastic bag in his head. But right now, we're giving away our secrets. Every time you download a freemium game, use a takeaway app, or read a news article, you give away your secrets. And that needs to stop, because sooner or later, some prick in power is going to think that China have the right idea. And then we have no choices. Did you hear that, Parliament? We need to take back our data. We need to regulate the people that control our online lives. And if they won't behave themselves, dismantle the fuckers. Just like that. Visual metaphor, that's what that is. It's a visual, that is the, not the craft, the art of television. In the meantime, hug your ma, rub your dog, and leave me alone to enjoy this river before it pixelates. God damn you, you've done it! You maniacs! You've pixelated it, you've done it! God damn you all to hell! You old bitch!